All right, here we go. The top 10 NXT, no NXT moments, but top 10 Raw moments for the 25th of January 2021. And I'm getting really personally tired of this. They're going to break up the, you know, the Hurt Business. I'm personally tired of his ass. I'm pulling for the damn, his other boys in the Hurt Business. They need to get rid of him. I was having a thing in my head that maybe they put Samoa Joe in there. He didn't have to wrestle, right? Samoa Joe could be just a, but put him in there. You know? Another thing that I always talk about, I've been talking about week after week before the Royal Rumble. Another guy that has to prove that he belongs in the Royal Rumble. He can't just declare. And then after him, what happened? Someone declared. You know, they didn't do that on SmackDown, but while Raw sure wanted to pick up the slack and, you know, They still lost. Oh, Slap Nuts lost. Maybe give him another 2-3 years and then they'll finally land and be someone that people will take seriously.
And his name is Mustafa.
See, Ali. He pronounces it that way. I hate when the announcers have to and the commentators have to pronounce it the way he does. You know, that's just ladies right. No! Women's right, I should say. Well, she's a lady, but yeah. Now Rick cares. You said earlier he's being kind of cocky towards his dumb daughter and not like looking like you don't care. Come on.
What can Morrison know? Not with the kick.
The weakest move in professional wrestling history. I've never been impressed with that move. Just look at the faces of the people in the Thunderdome. They know they're in on it. The different filming wardrobe change to make her look like she's, you know. Like I said last week, there was somebody that looked like he wasn't impressed or he was bored. He was just like annoyed. It's like, you know what I mean? It's great for us watching at home. It's great, you know, but. And I think I saw someone at the top middle wasn't there when she changed.
And now Nia Jax all alone with Dana Brooke in the center of the ring. Looks they're trying to fight it off.
Oh, pretty fine. Pretty brutal.
Nasty. And this is going to be worse. Oh, and follows it up with the leg drop. Nia Jax gets the victory for her team.
You got to fight.
Well, no one said declared, but I don't mind Edge declaring for the Royal Rumble. He deserves to do that. But WWE, you know, what are you doing? Like, some declare and some don't have to, and some have to, or some have to qualify and some just declare. I mean, you know. Now, this was actually a good segment, but because it was quick and to the point.
Right.
And anytime you see Morrison and Miz be taken out, makes my day. Morrison needs to stay off of the damn bike. He cannot talk promo, cut a promo for shit.
Oh my God.
I love this.
Randy Orton.
His face, man, damn.
Oh my God, an RKO.
Men on women contact. It's happening more. We had that Sasha Banks and Reginald match. Right, you had that match, and you know that was a pretty good match. And then you have this. You know, it's been a long time since he gave an RKO to a female. The last time was the Nia Jax at the Royal Rumble. Yeah. But I'll tell you straight up, there are some women that are in WWE that wrestled with men, and I think that they can take the ass whooping, and they can take the beatings, they can take the physicality. Because look at Asuka. If you watch a match, Asuka one-on-one with Tajiri, you know how tough Tajiri is, right? She had a match with him and he was brutalizing her. So you know that Asuka can take that physicality. Nia Jax can. I'm sure Shayna Baszler can. You know, intergender matches are where it should be heading towards. But in the day and age that we live in now, you know, who knows if they can pull that off. Or, you know, the women would have to be the one, like in Sasha Banks' case. I think that's what they go for, that she was the one that was dominating the guy and she beat the guy. And that's probably what they go for. You don't want a guy, you know, brutalizing a woman in the ring, you know what I mean? Or taking physicality to the ring, or to the women in the ring. But like I said, you know, Candice LeRae, you know, before she came to WWE, she was having intergender matches. So, you know, Raw, the go home show, I liked the fact that the Goldberg and Drew McIntyre segment was quick and to the point. Because Goldberg is like that. The wrestling-wise has to be quick to the point. It's either going to be Goldberg's going to wipe him out, Drew McIntyre, and get the title like that, or Drew McIntyre is going to do like that too. Because if he did that to Brock Lesnar in 5 minutes, he beat him at WrestleMania. Why in the hell would he beat? Couldn't he beat a guy that's 10 years older than Brock? You know? And then we saw, like I said, we saw Alexa Bliss for various transformations, right? And then Orton hits her with the RKO. So what's happening to Orton at the Royal Rumble? He's out of the Royal Rumble. I don't think he's in it. Oh no, he actually said he was. Yeah, that's right. Yes, there's people that were rumoring saying that he was going to be out of that because he was going to face the Fiend. He might face the Fiend. You never know. What are the matches for Royal Rumble, right? Aside from the Royal Rumble matches, we have the WWE title match. We have the Universal title match. What other matches do we have? A lot of them are throwing their hat into the Royal Rumble. So, you know, what other matches are there? The women's tag team matches. Okay. Intercontinental title match. No. United States Championship match? No, because Lashley's going to be in the Royal Rumble. Edge is in the Royal Rumble. He is definitely my all-time favorite wrestler. You know, him, and then Bret Hart. And then I'd say Hogan, you know. Hogan was the one that made me, you know, get that whole, what do you call it, fever for wrestling. You know, Hulkamania, when he dropped a leg on Iron Sheik and became the WWE champion. And that's what started it. So, you know, I have no shame in saying that Hogan is one of my favorites. Now, for the go-home show, it was okay. You know, they got everything out there. And, you know, I mean, like I said, I still have issues. And, you know, it's going to be over with once the Royal Rumble starts. But my issues with... Let's give somebody a just declare. They could just declare. And it doesn't even have to be the top tier. It could be the lower tier, the mid tier ones, right? And then there's some that have to qualify. Ricochet, Drew Gulak, R-Truth. So it pretty much shows that they ain't shit. WWE don't give a fuck about them. They don't have to. They can't declare. They have to qualify, and then they lose. You know what I mean? Don't be surprised when you'll see them, you know, in the Royal Rumble anyway. That's gonna happen. Hopefully we see some NXT UK people in there as well. It'd be great to see that. Adam Cole, you know, maybe Lars Sullivan. He's not on NXT or NXT UK, but he's been gone. Maybe he'll make his return. Who knows? Does anybody care? I don't know. But you know, that's my video. That's my reaction to the top 10 Raw moments for the 25th of January 2021, and that is my thoughts rundown on Raw itself. You know, it was okay. know, a decent go-home show, but could have been better. But same time, people were able to get their shit in, their promos in, trying to establish some rivalries and continue some heat between people like Charlotte and Lacey. But yeah, that's my video. So for those of you who stopped by, checked it out, appreciate it. Great day. And oh, I was looking at because I paused the video for the Raw thing, and I thought it wasn't recording. I'm looking at the Raw thing because I have it and it's my recording part in a separate part of my screen. So I'm kind of freaking. I go, oh shoot, no. But anyway, that's my video. And for those of you who stopped by, checked it out, appreciate it. And in closing, as always, take care.